Hello everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Sure great to see you today. John Fix and I found a couple of super Kraeuter tools headlined by a nice 10-inch giant pair of Kraeuter pliers. They're in need of a lot of love. We're going to have to get them looking right so we can redo the display. So let's get on down to the shop and get started.
Well, I've scored a couple of really nice Kraeuter tools that we're going to restore today. First is this 10-inch pliers. I don't know if they make them any bigger than that, but that is a large set of pliers. I don't have anything like this. I've just got a small pair. But these are in really sad shape. Whatever putting on here is pretty much gone. It's got the nice embellishments on the handle, if you can see through the patina. But it's rusty and dirty everywhere. Got to be taken apart and cleaned down to the bare metal and refinished. Really nice, nice set of pliers. It's got a screwdriver tip on this end. And really looking forward to restoring these. I can't see a part number on them, which I might be able to see. Not positive what it says, so I'll have to wait till it's cleaned. And here's a little pair of cutters. They're really tight. Can't get them all the way open, so they're going to have to be loosened up and lubricated. And I noticed these don't have any, like all the Kraeuters I have, they every one of them have a nice pattern on the handles. These have none. So it maybe when these were done, this was either, it looks like it was darkened, so it was probably gun blue, or it could have had a coating on it. I don't know. But we want to get them cleaned up and working right, and there's no gap in the jaw there. So the jaw is real nice and tight. Looks like a Kraeuter USA. Don't see a model number on here. But we're going to clean these both up today and probably have to take my display down off the wall and put it back up on there, repositioning everything. To try to squeeze two more tools in there, but I definitely want these up on my display. So the first thing will be to clean them and then wire brush them. Well, we'll do a little before and after with just the wire brushing segment. This is half of the pliers to show you what I started with. It was pretty bad. And after a good bit of wire brushing, we're here. So you can see a big improvement so far. Here's a good side-by-side to get a look at them here. And so these were really, really in need of some work. The thing about it is, while that wire brushing, like I said, it cleans up a lot, but it uncovers a lot, too, of stuff that needs to be done. Basically, if you look close on here, there was either a chrome or a nickel plating on here that just is still on here, off and on in spots, that needs to come off. So the only way to get that off is going to be through sanding. So we did a good initial cleanup with the wire brush, but it's going to need a lot more work to get through it. Like I said, got the surface taken care of. Some nicks and scratches and bumps and so forth, but a full restoration is going to be a matter of completely sanding this, really scrubbing it down to get it down to the base bare metal, and then polish it up from there. So the next step is getting it down to the base metal and, of course, getting this side caught up with this one. Well, I'll take you back to the beginning with these Kraeuter pliers. They were These were dingy and dirty, but these were really dingy, dirty, pitted, scratched. Had seen a lot of hard use over the years. So they both needed a restoration. I didn't show you much in the way of restoring on these little pliers, cutters, because mainly all I had to do was just clean up the faces of them here, the back and the front, say, and the sides. I didn't do anything to the handles except scrub them with a Scotch-Brite and then finish them off with a 4-ounce steel wool and then put a coat of wax on them. The black color was fine on there. I'm assuming that's the way they came originally. There was no embellishment on the handle like on the standard pliers. But you can see, shows up well, Kraeuter USA 450-6 inch pair. So they cleaned up nice. They look good. They look good on the display. And a definite nice improvement from the dingy ones I got. These were the real piece of work. And as I showed you, I took them and just completely sanded them down to the bare metal. And shined them. I had to use the grinder, the angle grinder with the flat disc to get this down. It was just, I couldn't get anything clean with hand sanding or my orbital sander. So I had to get out the muscle, and so I got out the good old 4.5-inch grinder with the flap disc that always does the job, and got every surface sanded down and smoothed, got it finished back to a shiny state, and topped it off to look like this. Definitely a giant improvement. By the way, this finish that I got on here is sort of a satin finish, and I did this the way I usually do them. I sanded them down after I wire brushed and then sanded and then put it on my surface conditioning belt to get to smooth out a lot of additional scratches and fine problem, you know, marks and so forth on there. And then I took my Scotch-Brite and just buffed it down completely where it was completely flat, and then polished it out with my 4-ounce steel wool. And that always just gives me that satin look. And that's what I wanted with these. It's Kraeuter 356-10, 10-inch. I call them giant pliers. They are really large, but they feel good, and I'm sure we could get some use for them. I just don't usually grab a pair of pliers that large when I'm going after something. I'll go with channel locks or something else. But these are beautiful, beautiful pliers. Everything, you know, Kraeuter specialized in pliers, and what's really nice is the handles, the embellishment on the handles. This just turned out super looking. They call it never slip. And it just gives you, you know, a good grip. They're not slick. They've got that on there rather than just putting a knurling on there like a lot of people do. They always put these nice designs. And this one is especially nice. Just beautiful. And they always put their names inside, too. Kraeuter USA on both insides of both handles. Just a classy way to do a tool. And just looks great. Feels great. Every surface smooth and finished to that satin finish. I've got to say that one of my nicest pair of pliers. I really enjoy these. Just the way they look, the way they feel, the way they work is just something you don't see, you know, in some pliers. So that was my Kraeuter restorations for the day. Next, if you'll stay tuned, I'm going to show you my whole Kraeuter collection. I've made up a new little design piece on there to show them off. So I'll show you what the whole collection looks like now that I've got it restored. And it's really looking great up on my wall. Thank you so much for watching my video. Here's my new display I just put up on the wall of my Kraeuter collection. I did something a little jazzy because their tools are superb. Every single tool I've gotten in the Kraeuter are well made, got nice designs, just solid, great items. And I really enjoy showing them off. And lucky me, I get to look at it every day. Thanks for watching my video.